Hey everybody, OVW here. So this video that I'm about to show you guys has been recorded like about a month ago, maybe? Yeah, it was about a month ago I recorded this video for you guys. And I just seen that I never did upload it. So here it is for you guys. This is the Stanfield Yarn Winder and Yarn Swift. So love you guys. God bless. Remember to keep God first and everything else second. Enjoy the upcoming clips.
Hey everybody, OVW here. So I'm going to show you, this is one of my favorite two items. If you get yarn like this in Hank's, then this yarn winder and this yarn swift is a must have to make yarn cakes like that. All right, so I'm going to show you. It's so easy to use. I will have a link down below to show where I got it from. It was about $70 for both, and it came rather quickly. This is a Stanwood Needlecraft Yarn Winder and Yarn Swift. All right, and this is a tabletop yarn swift. Just excuse my tripod sitting right there. But yeah, so I'm gonna show you how to use it. So once you open up your yarn, you're gonna put it on your adjustable yarn swift. It has different holes for different sizes of your hank. All right, then you want to pull it on over here to the yarn winder and get busy with this winding. Okay, so you just find your end piece of your yarn, your starting piece, and I usually just tie like a double knot. So I'm just going to do a double knot here. Okay, then you bring it over here to the threader. Right here, I just wrap it around twice. I don't go trying to go through the eye of it. All right, and then you put it on the little splits that they have right here. Okay, so I'm going to put it on there, having my knot on the outer side. Okay, and now you're just going to spin it clockwise. When the yarn swift is going to go clockwise as well. And you just wind it up. Go as fast or as slow as you want. Sometimes you gotta take your time because then the yarn might get tangled up. But if you put it on your yarn swift the correct way, it won't get tangled. But sometimes I encounter tangles. But basically you just wind it up until you come to the right size. Let me stop for a minute. As you can see, this is a big hank. I believe this is about maybe 900 yards. This only does a 4 ounce cake ball, so usually that's about 200 to 300 yards. So I've already did one out of one hank, so I'm gonna try to get it to match the same size as this one here. Okay, so I'm just gonna keep winding. Like I said, you can go as fast as you want. Or as slow as you want. Show you my hand action here. And this just attaches to your table or wherever you want to attach it to, that it has a ledge where it could hook onto. And you just kind of just spin. I kind of hold the thread a little bit for a little extra tension. But sometimes it might get tangled and then I can easily stop it. See, I can just go like this and stop it instead of it stopping and tangle this all up. Okay. This is definitely a must have. It's actually fun. I let Buttercup try it, but she kept going clockwise, counterclockwise, tangling my yarn up. So I was like, nope, you got to get better coordination, baby girl. But this is actually really fun. So I'm going to stop it to see how far is my cake ball. It's almost the same size. So I'm just going to go ahead and finish it out. As you can see, it's almost done. So I'm going to slow it down just a tad bit. Just a tad bit. Slow it down. Okay, so it got a little tangled in there. And that happens sometimes. The cool thing about this is that this comes in pieces. So I could just take it off and get it untangled. And since it's just a little bit, I could just hold it here and just spin it till I'm done. Okay, and so then I double knot my end piece here. And then I just kind of stick it in between the threads here so it'll stay like that. And then the next thing you do, I find my end piece, my beginning piece here, and have it out. And then I just pull it off, and there's your cake ball. So two cake balls out of one skein. And sorry about Azaria whining. And this actually, so yeah, I really like this combination. There is different yarn swifts to choose from. There is a different yarn winder, I think it's red and white. This one is blue and white. There's an electrical one, but I like the yarn winding because you have control over the pace you go. And yeah, I think this is a definite get for those of you who get lots of yarn in hanks like this, or you can hand wind it, but I've had terrible experience hand winding, so or working straight from the skein. So I just wanted to share this with you guys. One of the cool little tools that I use when I'm crafting, and I will have the link down below. And give this video a thumbs up, and I will see you guys in the next video. And if you're not a subscriber, go ahead and subscribe now, because I put out videos pretty often. They may not be crochet related, but hey, it's a video, right? Love you guys. God bless. Remember to keep God first and everything else second. Bye, you guys.